It's that ability to adapt and thrive by adopting new technology. And you've really seen that, you know, with COVID, a lot of operators have embraced technology sooner than maybe they had planned to, in an industry that really has been slow to embrace technology when you really look at, you know, in the last 5-10 years. So it's been great to see.
Hello, and welcome to Sink or Swim, a biweekly podcast brought to you by Rentsync, where we provide an insider's look into the PropTech, multifamily, and rental housing industry. In each episode, we take a deep dive into the technologies and strategies that have helped companies overcome operational challenges and increase the value of their multifamily investments. So, without further delay, let's get into today's discussion. Welcome to episode 0 of Sink or Swim, a new podcast by Rentsync. We're here today with Mitch Fanning, the VP of Marketing for Rentsync and the host of the show. How's it going today, Mitch?
Well, I'm good because if we're having this conversation, it means one thing. We've actually launched the podcast.
To give everyone a little bit more context, my name is Nicolina Savelli and I'm one of the producers of Sink or Swim. And today we'll be talking to you about what you, the listener, can expect from this podcast. But before we jump into that, Mitch, can you tell us a bit about yourself?
Sure. So as you've already said, I'm the VP of Marketing at Rentsync, formerly LWS or Landlord Web Solutions. And I would say that I would kind of refer to myself as a serial early stage tech executive. And that's probably because I've held leadership roles at 3 early stage tech companies. Actually, Rentsync would be one of those 3. All have been on the Growth 500. And as you know, Rentsync was on the Growth 500 list, which is a list of Canada's fastest growing companies. Rentsync was on that list. At that time, we were Landlord Web Solutions or LWS, and they were number 94. Mm-hmm. One kind of fun fact that probably most people don't know is I managed my own small real estate portfolio at one point. But other than that, I don't really have a background in multifamily, which is actually why I wanted to start this podcast.
Right. So that leads me to my second question then. Why did you want to start this podcast for Rentsync?
Yeah. So, I mean, obviously I cheated a little bit because I got into that next question. I would say really it was, you know, selfishly to learn more about this industry myself. And I think everyone here at Rentsync has been great in really sharing their knowledge. And a lot of the clients I've talked to have shared, you know, a lot with me as well. But I think just having a format to, on a regular basis, learn more about the industry was really something that I wanted to have. But I also think it's going to be something where even others who have a lot of experience in the industry will get a lot of value from and learn a lot from as well. And not just from the people on our team who I would say are industry experts. You know, the idea here is I want this podcast to be a place where industry operators can come on and share their stories, both success and failures, and really take a deep dive into some of the marketing and tech strategies that have helped them, you know, overcome some of their challenges. And right. I guess that's why we called it Sink or Swim, right? But it's that ability to adapt and thrive by adopting new technology. And you've really seen that, you know, with COVID. A lot of operators have embraced technology sooner than maybe they had planned to, in an industry that really has been slow to embrace technology when you really look at, you know, in the last 5-10 years. So it's been great to see.
So tell me a little bit more about Rentsync. I know you're part of the whole relaunch of the rebrand from Landlord Web Solutions to Rentsync. So what is this company and its mission moving forward?
Well, as you know, we're really here to provide marketing solutions for the multifamily industry. We actually just launched a new website, rentsync.com, and you know, a lot of that's going to be there for people to take a look at. And I really encourage people to do that. But we have been around since 2010, which most people in Canada know. And we actually just celebrated our 10th anniversary in terms of being in business on July 1st. Now, if you are new to Rentsync or Landlord Web Solutions in general. Before that, obviously, we were LWS. But I would say at this point, you know, really to answer that question, you have to answer it in three parts. One, why they started, and two, why the rebrand, and three, what's next, right? I actually haven't had a lot of experience telling the origin story, the original co-founders, Jason Leonard, worked at a property management firm. And that's where he met David Koski, who's one of the other original co-founders. And then there's Michael Modula. But they all kind of identified a problem and they came out with a solution. They noticed that at the time, there was a lot, you know, the landlords had really a poor web presence. And that's really how it began, right? It began by them talking about doing some web design work for landlords back in 2010. And that led to kind of ad syndication and the rest of the history. But they, when they started doing that, they realized that the kind of content management systems that were out there, there was really none that were purpose-built. So that's kind of how they had to build their own. And really, like I said, the rest is history from there. It's been a great journey. Why the rebrand? When you think about it, there's been a big disconnect between what the company has been doing and has done over the last 10 years and versus what it will be doing in the near future. And I think that was really the catalyst. There was a lot of other reasons, right, but I think that was one of the biggest reasons. Sure. And then obviously that brings us to what's next, right? I think what's next is really to position Rentsync as that leading provider of marketing solutions for multifamily in North America. And, you know, we're already getting there because despite COVID, we have been growing. And last year we were I was number 34 and now we're 51. And we actually onboarded nine people in the last 2 months, which is, it's been really incredible.
Completely remotely.
Which yeah, exactly.
Which is pretty crazy. When we go back, it's going to be like the first day of school and all the new kids are there and it's going to be great.
Yeah, I'm seeing all these new faces on Slack. You know, it's been really fun.
Yeah, the group chat is just growing every single day. I'm like, this person's just joined. I don't even know what their function is yet, but I'm sure I'll find out.
You know, exactly.
Okay, so what can listeners expect then to hear when they listen to each episode of Sink or Swim? I think you've kind of touched on it, but maybe a little bit closer to who and what is going to be presented in each episode and what they're going to take away from this podcast.
Sure. Yeah. You know, as I've said, it's really about having meaningful conversations with operators and professionals in the multifamily or rental housing industry who are, you know, prepared to really share their stories of their success and failures, like I've mentioned, and really how tech has really helped them thrive in and help them grow. But, you know, I think, and I guess if I, you know, as far as the format, we want to do it biweekly and we want to do a lot of interviews, of course. But I think if you ask me about what's the long-term vision for this, and obviously this is just an experiment at this point, but the long-term vision for this is really to turn this podcast maybe into a network of sorts and maybe spin out some multiple shows. And maybe at some point we can call the whole thing Rentsync Radio.
Yeah, that's something that we've been toying with. So hopefully after this episode, we'll keep brainstorming and thinking of new ideas of what kind of content people want to listen to. So if you're listening to this, how can they connect with us in case they have ideas for episode topics or even different channels that we might spin out or guests that we should feature on the show?
Yeah, it's a great question. At this point, we want feedback. But in this case, for those who are listening, if you want to be on the show or if you have an idea, of course, they can reach out to you, Nick, and they can use the email podcast@rentsync.com, or they can reach out to me, mitch@rentsync.com, or they can just look me up on LinkedIn and Mitch Fanning and just send me a note there.
Yeah, wherever you can find us, we'll respond. Our social media channels, obviously, as well. If that's the easiest or fastest way to contact us, you can do it there as well. Well, that wraps up episode zero. So stay tuned for more episodes of Sink or Swim, where Mitch tackles the ups and downs of the prop tech, multifamily, and rental housing industry. Thanks for letting me take over the reins today, Mitch. And no problem. I'm sure we'll meet here again.
We sure will.
You've reached the end of another episode of Sink or Swim. Make sure to visit us at rentsync.com/podcast to access show notes, key takeaways, and where you can sign up to our newsletter to receive free bonus content. If you found value in this show, please also remember to rate, review, and subscribe. That's this week's episode of Sink or Swim. Don't forget to join us next time for another jam-packed episode. Thanks for listening.